So I'm glad morning when this life is all around. Fly away to a home on God's distant shore. I'll fly away. Oh, I'll fly away. Oh, glory, I'll fly away
in the morning
when I die. Hallelujah, by and by.
I'd like to say good evening to everyone. Thank you for welcoming us out to your home through the television tonight. We're just here to have church with you tonight and just uplift the name of Jesus Christ and proclaim His kingdom. And you know, before we get into it, I'd like to say and take just a minute to say to any of you out there that's ever served in the military, thank you, and we salute you tonight.
Amen.
Because Veterans Day is very important to us. We know without your all's service, we wouldn't have this country. So we thank you for that. If there's a number on the bottom of the screen, if you have any prayer requests or song requests, we'll do all the prayer requests and as many of the song requests as we can. But you know, like I said, we're just here to have church with you. I know there's people out there watching that don't get to go to church. This may be the only church they have, and we just pray that what we do tonight will bless them. And if there's somebody out there watching tonight that hadn't accepted Christ as their Savior, do so tonight. It may be the last chance you get, and I guarantee you, if you do, you'll not regret it.
Amen.
Before we get into the service, I'm going to ask Brother Darrell if he'll have a blessing on the service.
Thank you, Heavenly Father, for another opportunity to be here tonight. And Lord, we thank you for all those, Lord, who are tuned in tonight. We just pray, Lord, that something we say in the song and the message, or just in word, Lord, that they would be blessed by what they hear this evening and touch each one and bless them. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Page 30, in case you haven't got it. And you know, it's there's a joy to serve the Lord, and a joy in salvation. So it's joy unspeakable.
I have found His grace is all complete. He supplieth every need. While I sit and learn at Jesus' feet, I am free and free indeed. Joy unspeakable and full of glory, in this joy unspeakable and full of glory, all that has never yet been told. I have found the pleasure I once craved, the joy and peace within. What a wondrous blessing, I am saved from the awful gulf of sin. In his joy unspeakable and full of glory, full of glory, full of glory. In his joy unspeakable and full of glory, oh, the half has never yet been told. I have found that hope so bright and clear, living in the realms of grace. Oh, the Savior's presence is so dear, I can see his smiling face. In his joy unspeakable and full of glory, full of glory, full of glory. In his joy unspeakable and full of glory, oh, the half has never yet been told. I found the joy no tongue can tell, how its ways of glory roll. It is like a great overflowing well, springing up within my soul. In your joy unspeakable and full of glory, full of glory, full of glory. It is joy unspeakable and full of glory, oh, the half has never yet been told.
Amen.
Page 31.
Won't it be wonderful there? You know, when we get to heaven, it's going to be wonderful there. I can just try to picture it, but I know the best I can picture isn't going to be half as good as what's going to be
there. Amen.
Won't it be wonderful there?
Let's go down to B flat on that thing.
When with the Savior we enter the glory land, won't it be wonderful there? And in the troubles and cares of the story land, won't it be wonderful there? Won't it be wonderful there? Having no burdens to bear, joyously singing with our bells all ringing, oh, won't it be wonderful there? Walking and talking with Christ the supernal one, won't it be wonderful there? Praising, adoring the matchless eternal one, won't it be wonderful there? Won't it be wonderful there? Having no burdens to bear, joyously singing with our bells all ringing, oh, won't it be wonderful there? There were the tempests will never be sweeping us, won't it be wonderful there? Sure that forever the Lord will be keeping us, won't it be wonderful there? Won't it be wonderful there? Bells all ringing, oh, won't it be wonderful there?
Page 36. You know, Thanksgiving's just around the corner. We'll be here before we even know it.
Yeah.
And one of the things that I personally am very thankful for is the old rugged cross.
Amen.
If Jesus hadn't gone to that cross, what would I have? Nothing. So I'm thankful for the old rugged cross and Jesus going to it for us.
On a hill far away stood an old rugged cross, the emblem of suffering and shame. And I love that old cross where the dearest and best for a world sinners was slain. So I cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last I lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown. Oh, that old despised by the world as a wondrous attraction for me. For the dear Lamb of God left his glory above to bear into dark Calvary. So I'll cherish the old rugged cross, till my trophies at last I lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross, and exchange it someday for a crown. In the old rugged cross, stained with blood so divine, a wondrous beauty I see. For it was on that old cross Jesus suffered and died. Cherish the old rugged cross, till my trophies at last I lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross, and exchange it someday for a crown. To the old rugged cross I will ever be true, his shame and reproach gladly bear. They will call me someday to my home far away, where his glory forever I'll share. So I'll cherish the old rugged cross, till my trophies at last I lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross, and exchange it someday for a crown.
Amen. What a beautiful old song. Now, we had a request to sing that song for Nathaniel Russell. So, Nathaniel, we hope and pray that you enjoyed that. And Holding Up the Ladder, do you all know that one? Ron?
I don't know.
I hope I don't have the words.
Okay, don't have the words? Okay, well, we won't be able to sing that one, but it says, if not, sing any song for Chelsea Brown. So, next song we do, we'll just do it. Ron, Flowers for Mama for Cat Channel. And Leash, play a song for Cat Channel. So, Cat, we're glad the cat's in the house tonight. Glad that you're here with us. We miss you being here singing alongside of us, but we know you're singing there at home. And we want Carrie Allender. Saw Gus the other day, and Gus told me that Carrie sang with us all the time. So, Carrie, you sing real loud now so I can hear you. I'm having a bad ear day, but if you'll pick her up, I'm sure I'll get tuned into the right channel here in a little bit. Also want to send the next song out to Archie Snyder. I know Archie watches all the time, and Archie, we're glad that you do and support us. We appreciate your prayers and all the help, and we're thankful for everyone that tunes into the broadcast, because we're here for one reason, and that's to uplift the name of Jesus Christ, that others might find it before it's eternally too late. I want to remember the next song for Mary Todd, too. I want to send it out to her. I'm sure that she's watching this evening and enjoying as well. What do you have?
We have 44, When We All Get to Heaven.
When We All Get to Heaven. Now, that right there is a dandy. You just listen to that, and if you know her, sing right along with us.
Sing the wondrous love of Jesus. Sing his mercy and his grace. In the mansion, bright and blessed, he'll prepare for us a place. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory. While we walk the pilgrim pathway, clouds will overspread the sky. But when traveling days are over, not a shadow, not a sign. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory. Let us then be true and faithful, trusting, serving every day. Just one glimpse of Him in glory will the goals of life repay. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be.
Praise the Lord.
When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory. Onward to the prize before us, soon His beauty will behold. Soon the pearly gates will open, we shall tread the streets of gold. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory.
Amen.
This time we'll turn it over to the pastor.
Woo! That's a good one.
That's good stuff.
I think we're all winning today.
Bless you, folks.
Bless you, Pastor. Better.
Bless you, Joe. Bless you, folks. Bless you, Amen Corner. Oh, we'd like to say good evening once again to each one of you. It's wonderful to be in the presence of God. Because wherever we are, we're in the presence of God. He watches over us every minute of every day, every moment of every night. God is watching, keeping His eyes over you. This evening, it's just good to be alive, as old brother Gail Smith used to say. It's good to be alive and know that you're a Christian. To know that our best days are just ahead of us. What a wonderful time it is going to be when we all get to heaven. I never sing that old song, but what I don't think of Brother Ped Lewis, and when I first started meeting up with him, when he was preaching for the Evangelistic Brethren, and most of all, he was preaching for the Lord, and we get in that old Big Ben church up there and start singing that old song, church would just be jam-packed with people, and it's made out of red brick, and you know, you could just almost see the sides of that old church weaving in and out as the Spirit of God was so great, and that song was being sung so well. There's nothing sweeter than a congregation of people singing together and magnifying and glorifying our Father, which is in heaven. If you have your Bibles with you this evening, we'd like for you to turn to the third chapter of the book of Colossians. The book of Colossians, the third chapter. We've got a few words we'd like to say to you, and these folks will come back and sing us off the air. We appreciate all of you that support us with your prayers, with finances, because without you, this wouldn't be possible. And I stopped over by my brother's house there this evening. Old Brother Buck or Brother Rennie, whatever you want to call him. I've got a few other names for the old boy. And gave a scanner to my sister-in-law, Iris, to sit there so Brother would know what news was going on. Whatever. She said, stick her tongue out at me, so I'll return the favor and just stick my tongue back at you. And, you know, we're just family here. Remember old Junior Hire used to call and ask me if we wanted to dig taters. He didn't think I'd say anything about it on the air. But, you know, I was thankful for old Junior and the time that we spent together. But he's done with the Lord. And many others that I know is on the other side. And sometimes I just want to stop for just a little bit and think about heaven. Let's just get the hearts and minds off the things of the world. Let's think about God for a little bit. Let's just close the old outside world out. Let's forget about all the problems. Let's forget about all the electioneering that's going on. And let's just think about God and His greatness and what He has done, is doing, and what I know He's going to do in the very near future. And how do I know? Because He said so in His Word. Colossians chapter 3, beginning with verse 1. And there it says, "If ye then be risen with Christ, seek those things which are above, where Christ sitteth on the right hand of God. Set your affections on things above, not on things on the earth. For ye are dead, and your life is hid with Christ in God. When Christ, who is our life, shall appear, then shall ye also appear with him in glory. Let us pray. O gracious and wise Heavenly Fathers, we enter your presence once again. Thank you, Lord, for your holy word. Thank you, Lord, for your Holy Spirit and the love that you shower upon us each day. Lord, so many wonderful things have happened today. We know that the miracles that have taken place are by your hand because all good things come from above. Lord, we ask tonight that you would bless your word, and the words that are about to be spoken would be your words. Not mine, but what you would have said, they would touch the hearts of your people. And Lord, if there's one that's lost, that they would find you before this evening was over. And for these things we ask in Jesus' name. And amen and amen. We look at this passage of scripture that Paul gave to the Colossian people as well as us today. And the Scofield Bible has that headed, "The Believer's Union with Christ Now and Hereafter." We have a union with Christ when we're united with him, when we get on our knees and we ask Jesus to be Lord of our life. Then we die within ourselves, and it's no longer us that liveth, but the Spirit that lives within us, this one called Jesus. Now we sing about the cross, and we sing about the splendors and glory. We sing about the Holy Spirit and God and Christ. But you realize that the only way that we can make it to this place that's called heaven is by Jesus Christ. 14th chapter of John, Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and life. No man cometh unto the Father but by Christ and Christ alone." Christ also said that I and my Father are one. And if I'm in the Father and you're in Christ, you see, that just brings us all together. And that's better than any family reunion that you've ever been to. Folks, God wants us one day to be assembled together on that other shore. I was thinking about Mom today, and, you know, her favorite song was "Sweet By and By." And, you know, in the sweet by and by, we're going to meet on that beautiful shore over there, along that river that flows down from the throne of God, and all of the problems and wars and all of the disasters, all of the things that's going on in your life here on this whole earth is not allowed to get into heaven. No heartache, no pain, no cancer, no heart disease, no eye problems, no ear problems. All of these things will be gone forever. Once you've left this old planet, folks, you're never going to have to see another doctor. You're never going to have another shot. You won't need another pill. You won't hear advertisements for everybody's medicine that makes you feel so good. And if you read the directions there of what side effects there was, you wouldn't take it anyhow. But I want you to know that God is a great physician. And he can heal you physically, spiritually, financially, any aspect of your life. He's Lord and God over all. Everything belongs to God. He said that he owns the cattle on 1,000 hills. And I'm sure he owns the hills that those cows are standing on. Folks, we look at his greatness. All the leaves are about down now, and wintertime fast approaching, and some people's looking forward to snow, and some people running south to get away from it, some people running north trying to get into it. Folks, people are running around, and most of them don't know what they want. But what they're really looking for is peace, looking for joy within their lives. And folks, money can't bring that to you. Worldly possessions can't bring that to you. The only peace that you ever have is the peace of knowing Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. Open your old heart's door and let him come in. He said if you'd open the door, he'd come in and sup with you and you with him, and he would be your God, and you would be his son or his daughter. And I'm so thankful for the day that I asked Jesus to be Lord of my life. Oh, I've made a lot of mistakes since then. I fell short in a lot of ways, and I pray every day, Lord, if I have said or done anything contrary to your will, or I've been an offense to anyone, forgive me, Lord, because I'm just an old sinner saved by your grace. Jesus knew that he'd have to give his life on Calvary and shed his life's blood that we could make it to heaven, because we couldn't do it by the law. There's no way that we could do that. We're not saved just because we're a member of a church or and some of the good deeds that we do, but we're saved by the blood that was shed on the cross. It's not the cross, but it's Christ that hung on the cross. If we had the cross this evening, that was beyond a shadow of a doubt, the exact one that Christ was nailed to there that day, you realize that cross couldn't save you? It certainly can't. It's not the cross that saves you. It's Jesus Christ. And Jesus said he's the only way. Anyone that tries to come in to heaven any other way is a robber and a thief. So first thing you have to do is deny yourself, take up the cross, and follow him. Where is Jesus sitting today? Scripture I just read in your hearing says that Jesus is sitting on the right hand of God. They're interceding for you and I. We're under the blanket coverage of Jesus' blood if we have asked Jesus to be Lord of our life. And when we sin, when we fall short, and we ask Jesus to forgive us, you see, he just covers us with the blood. And when the Father looks down, he sees you just as clean and pure as his own son that hung there on the cross that day. A lot of people says, well, if God's as merciful as you say, he's not going to put anybody in hell. Well, you're right, he won't. We do that to ourselves. Anyone that doesn't accept Christ, you've been given a way out. God always gives us a way out. He never closes the door, but what he does is open up a window of hope. And we have to put our faith and trust in the Lord and the Lord alone. And whenever we know and realize that Jesus is sitting on the right hand of God, then we need to look up and look to Jesus, because all good things come down from heaven. All good things are given. The sun, the rain, and the wind circuits are all above us. And the book of Ecclesiastes tells us that, you know, all of the creeks run into the river and the rivers into the ocean, but still yet they're not full. Now try to understand all the things that God does. I was standing out the other night looking up into the heavens, probably about 11:30, and man, those stars were shining so bright and so beautiful. And you realize that God has every one of those numbered, and he knows exactly why. You've got them named, I'm sure. And he knows you, and he knows me personally. Whether you know God or not, he's watching over you. There was years in my life that if God hadn't taken care of me, I wouldn't be here today. And God still takes care of me every day. And I ask for the Lord's guidance and direction, because one day I want to go home to be with him forever. I'm not getting any younger. I'm getting older. And I've said, I might grow old, but I'm not growing up. I drove school bus for 32 years, and I learned how to be a kid all over again. And folks, I'm going to have a good time. I'm going to praise the Lord wherever I'm at. And I love telling people about Jesus Christ and proclaiming him as King of Kings and Lord of Lords. God gives us a wonderful opportunity here on Monday nights that thousands of people I know watch this broadcast. And it's a wonderful privilege to stand here and to tell you how wonderful Christ is. I know there's a lot of people that won't go to church that will watch this broadcast. And I'm thankful for every one of you that watch. And I pray that the Spirit will move in your life at one point or time, and then you'll find that desire to accept Jesus, find that desire to go to church. You don't have to go to church with me. There's a lot of good churches out there, and there's a lot of good Bible-based churches. People love the Lord. Just go where people really trust in God and pray and work and be faithful. And I'll tell you, the Lord will bless you abundantly in measures that we can't understand. The Scripture tells us that, you know, when Christ appears, we still really don't understand what we shall be. But we know when we meet him, we're going to be just like him. And that's going to be just fine. You know, the old songs go, a mansion, a harp and a crown and a white robe. Now, I never did like to wear a robe. I don't know that I want one. But if God gives me one, that's exactly what I want. Whatever the Lord gives me, I thank him for. And you know, he said, even in his word, if you go out visiting, you stay with somebody, you eat what's set before you. There have been a few times I've had to eat a little old cream cheese or some of this other stuff. Man, I can't hardly cut it. But, you know, the Lord said he watched that before you. Do the best you can with it. I may not want the whole piece, but I'll try. Do the best I can. And, you know, God always places us where we need to be. We need to pray one for another, and we need to get our sights on heaven. He said, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and then everything else will be added. Don't worry about what you don't have. Don't worry about what you can't do. And don't worry about things you can't do anything about anyhow. You need to spend your time in prayer and meditation, thanking God as you meditate. Saying, Lord, I thank you for your word. I thank you, Jesus, for the cross. I thank you for the cradle. And I thank you for all the great things that you've done. As Ron mentioned this evening about the veterans, I thank God for each one of you veterans. Whether you were in the military in peacetime or in wartime, I thank God that you answered the call to your country or volunteered and went and served in our armed forces. You know, Ron was an old Marine himself. He's not quite as mean or lean as he used to be, but he's still a Marine. And, you know, that just kind of sticks with you. Along the way. I believe probably Ronnie and Governor Powell was in the same outfit together. Not sure, but they might have been. But I do know that God wants us to be workers in his vineyard. We are all soldiers in God's army, and we need to stand firmly on the foundation, and the foundation is Jesus Christ. Any other religion is just not going to cut it. If they leave Jesus Christ out, they've left out the only thing that's going to take us to heaven. So let's trust in the Lord with all of our heart, knowing and realizing that all good things come from the Lord. The Spirit is so good here this evening. I could preach for another 3.5 hours, but I better let these fellas sing just a little bit. And knowing and realizing as we get requests, I know there's many people that watch, like my old brother Rich. He sits up there on Old Bailey Ridge and watches this broadcast, and he'll call in occasionally or whatever. And there was 11 of us in family, and none adopted, made 12 of us. I'm sure Mom wanted to knock us all in the head at some time, but God's good all the time. And it's wonderful that God established marriage and family so we can understand a small part of his love for us. If you don't know Christ, accept him as your Savior. It'll be the smartest thing you ever did. Prayer request tonight: Julie McDaniels, Mike Collins and family, Randy Collins, Lonnie Collins, Ethel Simons, Mary Godfrey, Bren, Dakota Tharp, Nathaniel Russell, Mary and Johnny Russell, Tom Reed, Christy Wilfon, John Ables, Glenna Tenney, Shirley, and Ernest Gifford, and the grandchildren, Jean Starr, Emma Zickafoos, for all the residents and staff at Obrooks, Bob and Janet Bennett, Dave and Betty Gould, Dave Convier, Betty Wengler. Haven't saw you folks in a while, but we're still praying for you. Lord bless you. Daphne Newland, Louise Hamner, Betty Harvey, Mary Brown, Ann Brown, all of the military, our schools, our churches, our ministers, for Israel, peace in Jerusalem, Cat Channel and family, Clifford and Christy Golden, for Jane Hurst, for Brenda Anderson, Waylon Tenney, Darlene Cutright, Juanita Wilson, Charlie Reed, Rodney Irvin Sr., Toots Bennett. God bless you, Toots. Glad you're watching this evening. I hope, pray the Lord's blessing. Opal Hill, Thelma Carpenter. Thelma, like the toboggan and the muffler you made. Appreciate that. Keith Gillum, and all those that have cancer, for Chelsea Brown, and for all the people that have been sick, and for Wayne Smith. We also want to remember Lawrence and Mady Hamner. Mom Wingfield, we pray that you're feeling better. Judy said you had a rough night there. We hope you're feeling better. For Virgil Helmick, Mary Todd, and for Anna Lee and Gary Cutright, and just many, many others we know. We try to pull them out of the top of our head, but it don't hold too much anymore. But if you're watching tonight, we're praying for you. Brother Woody Elstalk, Woody, if you're watching tonight, pray the Lord's blessing you. And of course, Gus and Carrie and Maynard, we're praying for you too. And Luella and Vanny, you're just a blessing. Appreciate you. And I just know God's going to bless these people. So let's just pray together. Trust in him together. And I know whatever need you have, God can fill it, without a doubt. Father, as we enter your presence this evening, we come praising and thanking you for another beautiful day. And Lord, this opportunity to pray for these folks that are written down on this list this evening. The others have been mentioned, and the others that, Lord, we know needs prayer. Maybe as it came to mind, but Lord, you know who they are. And we ask for your richest blessings. Heal the one that needs healed. Uplift the one that needs uplifting. Comfort the one that needs comforted. Lord, we leave them safely in your care, the safest place they can be. And Lord, we pray for those that are lost. We pray that you'll touch and move in their life by your Holy Spirit. And Lord, they'll accept you as Savior of their life. And for all these things we ask, in the sweet name of Jesus we pray. And amen and amen. May the Lord bless you and keep you till we be with you again. If you folks come on by, appreciate you. Bless you, Ronnie.
Well, I'll share about three songs with you tonight. And first one I want to do is Let's Meet by the River. I don't want to send it out to Vanny Cornell, Gus Allender and her husband, Carrie, Cleo Wingfield, for Teddy, for Llewellyn Maynard Hannafin, Harold and Elsie Lewis, for Ronnie Rogers and Janet, for Jesse Friend, for Archie Snyder, too. Let's Meet by the River. I read of a city John saw coming down from God out of heaven. The walls are of jasper, the gates are of pearls, and the streets of pure gold. He tells of a pure river of life that flows from the throne. And when we have reached that beautiful place, we'll know as we're known. Let's meet by the river, over on that beautiful shore. Let's meet by the river where loved ones dwell who's gone on before. If you leave here first, just wait by the river. If I leave you here, that's where you'll find me. Let's meet by the river, over on that beautiful shore. If you leave me standing here on this earth, just wait by the river. It's such a good place for us to meet over there. And after I find you, let's go see Jesus. And then let's find our dad and mother. Let's meet by the river over on that beautiful shore. Let's meet by the river over on that beautiful shore. Let's meet by the river where loved ones dwell who's gone on before. If you leave here first, just wait by the river. If I leave you here, that's where you'll find me. Let's meet by the river over on that beautiful shore. Let's meet by the river, over on that beautiful shore. Let's meet by the river where loved ones dwell who's gone on before. If you leave here first, just wait by the river. If I leave you here, that's where you'll find me. Let's meet by the river, over on that beautiful shore. Let's meet by the river, over on that beautiful shore. Next song I want to do is Lord, I'm Depending on You. I want to send it out to Barry Backner and his wife, Charlie Allen and his wife, all my friends that knew me back when I was into the sin. Also want to send it out to George Lawrence. Lord, I'm depending on you. When I face every trial of each day that passes by, I know the Lord is with me, and he hears me when I cry. And I know he'll not forsake me, he will lead me safely through. Lord, precious Lord, I'm depending on you. Lord, I'm depending on you. When I'm in the valley, you're leading me through. When the storm clouds are gathered, You make my gray skies turn blue. Lord, precious Lord, I'm depending on you. Now you may put your trust in riches, you may put your trust in man, but I'll put my trust in Jesus, for he's holding to my hand. Oh, this friend will never fail me, and he'll do the same for you. Lord, precious Lord, I'm depending on you. Lord, I'm depending on you. When I'm in the valley, you're leading me through. When the storm clouds are gathered, you make my gray skies turn blue. Lord, precious Lord, I'm depending on you. When the storm clouds are gathered, you make my gray skies turn blue. Lord, precious Lord, I'm depending on you.
Amen.
This next song by request for Cat Channel, my good buddy Cat. This is his favorite song. I also want to send it out to Ernie and Shirley Gifford and their grandchildren and Gene Starr. I also send it out to my sister-in-law, Cheryl Chavez. She likes this song too very well. And Flowers for Mama. Papa brought flowers for Mama today, and all the grown children, but it's not Mother's Day. I don't have no money, not even a dime, but I brought Mama flowers like I have all the time. Each day I pick flowers from this pretty hill, a small bunch of daisies and a few daffodils. I bring them to Mama at the end of the day and say, flowers for Mama, here's Mama's bouquet. They'd brighten her face and she'd hold me so close. She'd say they were more precious than a beautiful rose. And she wore a smile sweeter than millions of flowers, a smile that I'll carry through life's darkest hours. Yes, Mama was lying there, and they told me that she'd passed away. And she was surrounded by flowers that outshine my bouquet. Oh, I know mine aren't fancy, but still all the while, when they placed them in her hand, I know I saw Mama smile. Flowers for Mama, I picked them today. Not very much, just a simple bouquet. I know Mom's not fancy, but up there above, she's the prettiest flower in God's garden of love. Yes, she's the prettiest flower in God's garden of love. God bless you all and good night.
Start this.
Alrighty, let's come on in.
Get your Easter day
fly away. Alright. Alrighty. I want to do a little instrumental here. Thank you. Melissa and I are going to do one. Had a request to do one on her harmonica, so.
This is for Cat Channel, for Evelyn Riffle, Thelma Carpenter, Opal Hill, and all my other friends.
Alas, and did my Savior bleed, and did my Sovereign die? Would he defoke that sacred head for sinners such as I? At the cross where I first saw the light, and the burden of my heart rolled away. It was there by faith I received my sight, and now I am happy all the day. Crimes that I had done, he groaned upon the tree. Amazing pity, grace unknown, and love beyond degree. At the cross where I first saw the light, and the burden of my heart rolled away. It was there by faith I received my sight, and now I am happy all the day.
Amen.
Well might the sun in darkness hide and shut his glories in, when Christ the mighty Maker died for man the creature's sin. At the cross where I first saw the light, and the burden of my heart rolled away. It was there by faith I received my sight, and now I am happy all the day. Drops of grief can ne'er repay the debt of love I owe. Here, Lord, I give myself away, 'tis all that I can do. At the cross where I first saw the light, and the burden of my heart rolled away. It was there by faith I received my sight, and now I am happy all the day.
The next song I'd like to send out to Mom and Dad, also to Joy, Joan, and Julie, and to Joe Miller, and also to Lawrence and Mady Hamner. Unclouded day indeed.
Oh, they tell me of a home far beyond the skies. They tell me of a home far away. Oh, they tell me of a home where no storm clouds rise. Oh, they tell me of an unclouded day. Oh, the land of cloudless day. Oh, the land of an unclouded sky. Oh, they tell me of a home where no storm clouds rise. Oh, they tell me of an unclouded day. They my friends have gone, and they tell me of that land far away, where the tree of life in eternal bloom sheds its fragrance to the unclouded day. Oh, the land of cloudless day, oh, the land of an unclouded sky. Oh, they tell me of a home where no storm clouds rise. Oh, they tell me of an unclouded day. A king in his beauty there, and they tell me that mine eyes shall behold, where he sits on the throne that is whiter than snow, in that city that is made of gold. Oh, the land of cloudless day, oh, the land of an unclouded sky. Oh, they tell me of a home where no storm clouds rise. Oh, they tell me of an unclouded day. They tell me that he smiles on his children there, and his smile drives their sorrows all away. And they tell me again, in that lovely land of unclouded day. Oh, the land of cloudless day. Oh, the land of an unclouded sky. They tell me of a home where no storm clouds rise. Oh, they tell me of an unclouded day. As the world looks upon me, as I struggle along, and they say I am nothing, but they are so wrong. In my heart I'm rejoicing, how I wish they could see. Thank you, Lord, for your blessings on me. There's a roof up above me, I'm a good place to sleep. There's food on my table and shoes on my feet. You gave me your love, Lord, and a fine family. Thank you, Lord, for your blessings on me. I know I'm not wealthy, and these clothes are not new, and I don't have as money, but Lord, I have you. And to me, that's all that matters, though the world may not see. Thank you, Lord, for your blessings on me. There's a roof up above me, I'm a good place to sleep. There's food on my table and shoes on my feet. You gave me your love,
I messed up, huh?
Let me hear one of the songs there, dude.
It's the first one.
There we go, too. There we go. Can you do that with me? Hear the call that rings from the throne. It springs to those who've gone astray. Saying, come ye men, and your load of sin there at the altar lay. You don't seem to heed, for the chain of priesthood crushes your desire. Be assured, my friend, if you still offend, he will set your fields on fire. If in sin you don't return, he will set your fields on fire. You have heard Jesus call, and in death your soul must fall. But my friend, if you desire, you may join a heavenly choir and rejoice with him free from every sin when he sets this world on fire. You have heard his voice in the soul rejoice that trusted in his grace. You have lost with sin and he knocked within, but still you hide your faith from the blessed Lord and his own true word, but still you say return. Leave the downward path, kindle not his wrath, or he'll set your fields on fire. If from sin you don't retire, he will set your fields on fire. You have heard Jesus call, and in death your soul must fall. But my friend, if you may join the heavenly choir and rejoice with every sin when he sets his world on fire. Make a friend the vice, make the sacrifice complete, turn from sin. Taking up the cross, counting earth as straw, let Jesus live within. When temptation come, keep on facing home to Satan, never harm. I'll rejoice and pray on that last rest day when he sets this world on fire. If from sin you don't retire, he will set your fields on fire. You have heard Jesus call, and in death your soul must fall. My friend, if you desire, you may join a heavenly choir and rejoice with him free from every sin when he sets this world on fire.
Amen.
We'll finish off with the instrumental. Lonesome valley, you gotta walk it by yourself, or nobody else can walk it for you. Now you gotta walk by yourself. Thank you and good night.